Hello and welcome to this video tutorial. Gareth here from tastytudes.com. In Photoshop, we have the ability to blend layers together. This opens up a new scope of creative possibilities. In this tutorial, I'm going to discuss blending modes and demonstrate what they are and how we can use them. By the end of this tutorial, you will have a good understanding of how to use blending modes. So to follow along with this video, you will need to open this document I have prepared especially for this tutorial. This document can be found in the Essential Practice folder in the Project folder. Now you can download this project folder for free, the download link is in the description. So with the project folder open, click Essential Practice, open the Blending Modes folder and open the Blending Modes PSD, and you should have something that looks like this. So what are blending modes? Blending modes are the ability to blend layers together in the Layers panel. We can use blending modes to create various visual effects in the canvas area. When we think about using blending modes, we can locate them over in the Layers panel. If we look closely at the top left-hand side, just left of the Opacity option, we can see a drop-down menu. If we click this, we can see a list. This is a list of all the possible blending modes we can use. So looking at this, we can see the list is divided into 5 sections. Each of these sections applies a particular type of blending mode. The top section applies darkness modes. The second section applies lightning modes. The third section applies contrast modes. The fourth section applies comparative modes. And the last section applies composite modes. Now, at this stage, this might mean nothing to you, but after a little experimentation, you will soon learn what these mean and the effects each blending mode has and which one will be right to use. So there seems to be a lot of modes here, but there are only a few that are commonly used. So let's take a look at how blending modes work. So with the document open, if we look over in the Layers panel, we can see that currently we have the Bird Smart Object layer at the bottom of the Layers panel and 3 layers above, but currently the visibility is turned off. We have a Paper layer, a Gradient layer, and another Bird layer, but this example has been flipped horizontal. So by now, we are pretty much familiar with the way layers work in the Layers panel. The Layers panel works on a hierarchy from top to bottom. The layers at the top will have the most visibility than any layer below. So to begin, I'm going to toggle the visibility of the paper layer. So currently we can see that because the paper layer is above the bird layer, we can no longer see the layer below. We learned in a previous tutorial that if we toggle the opacity of a layer on top of another layer, we can begin to see the image through it. So I'll toggle the visibility of this paper layer to 50%. Well, this is interesting, but the effect is not that convincing. If we want to create the illusion that the bird image belongs to the crumpled paper, this is not going to be all that convincing. So I'll put the layer back to 100%. So what I'm going to do now is use a blending mode to blend the paper with the bird image to get a more convincing visual effect. So with the paper layer selected, I'll come up to the blending modes on the top left of the Layers panel, click the tab, and from the list I'm going to choose Multiply. Upon click, the paper layer above has blended with the bird layer below, and that's looking a lot more convincing. So why did we use the Multiply blending mode there? Well, let's change the blending mode currently applied to the paper layer. So let's come back up to the blending mode, and this time come down and click on Overlay. So upon click, this has a completely different effect. This is making our image look way too bright. If we come back to the blending modes categories, we can see that the overlay blending mode is part of the contrast category, thus creating a contrasting bright effect. So if we come back and apply the multiply, we can see this is the right effect to use, to make the paper look like it's part of the bird layer below. This is because the multiply layer is part of the darken modes. All the white in the paper layer will become transparent and the black in the image will blend with the layer below, thus darkening the image, giving us this effect. So if this effect seems too intense, I can now simply come over to the opacity of the paper layer and just tweak this until I'm happy. Nice. So the next layer I have above the paper layer is a gradient layer. So I'll toggle the visibility of this. So what I want to do here is blend this gradient on top of the layers below. So with the layer selected, I'll come up to blending mode and this time apply a blending mode of overlay. Now we can see the gradient blend with the paper and the bird layer below, and that's looking quite interesting. Now let's come back to the blending mode and click on saturation. We can now see an entirely new effect taking hold. So I'll come up and change the blending mode to one of the lightened modes. I'll choose screen, and we can see the effect that is having. Screen being a lightening mode, it's having an overall lightening effect. So various blending modes apply various effects. So I'll change this one back to overlay, one of the contrast modes, and I'll tweak the opacity just to decrease the intensity. So next in the layers panel, I have a bird raster layer. I'll toggle the visibility of this. So this is the same image as below, but has been flipped horizontal. So let's take a look at how an image can look set as a blending mode. So with the layer selected, I'll come up to blending modes and give this a lightning blending mode of screen. Now we can see that this layer is blending with every layer below and has applied an overall lightning effect. I'll change the opacity of this layer to 80%, and that's looking pretty interesting. Now let's come back to the blending mode option, and this time I'll apply a composite blending mode of luminosity, and check that out. That's pretty cool, right? So now we have three layers on top of the original layer, all with their own unique blending mode applied, creating this interesting visual effect. Now, we must keep in mind that blending modes work to the usual layer panel hierarchy system, from top to bottom. So now we have this particular layer structure in the layers panel. If, for example, I now come in and select the paper layer and move this to the top of the layer structure, we will see that layer and its blending mode will become more prominent because it's now on the top. So when using blending modes, you must pay close attention to the layer structure and the hierarchy. As you use various layers and blending modes, it's all about the combination and the structure that can determine the overall effect. You will come to realize that there are endless possibilities of the combinations of layers and blending modes you can explore to create various visual effects. So be sure to take some time to experiment and explore the blending modes on offer. Keep in mind the various categories of blending modes that are on offer, so you can apply the right blending mode to capture the right effect you're looking for. So that's how to use blending modes in Photoshop. Well, this brings us towards the end of the essential practice section on this course. Over the last 14 episodes, we have learned some of the key features a beginner should be familiar with as they begin using Photoshop. In Photoshop, once a project is complete, there are a wide range of formats you can save out your image to. It all comes down to what the image will be used for. In the next video, we are going to learn the various formats that can be saved in Photoshop. See you in the next video.